What's going on, everybody? It's your favorite dating coach, Elliot Scott. And as you can see by the title below and the background,
that we about to change some things up.
Hopefully you like my background. I had to put this shit together like that. So I got some humping animals, right? Got to get some Animal Planet up in here, some education, some Ninja Turtles, some Pokemon. I can't adult today. Actually, I shouldn't have that. That's very unproductive. Let's not have that one. You know, just a lot of things going on around here. Some good books you need to read. Whatever, right? But that's not what's important. What's important is I need to answer your questions. I feel like it's my civil duty, right? It's my civil duty to answer your questions. You guys have comments and down in my videos, and you're asking them for a reason. And I'm your boy, so I'm gonna answer them. And that's what this whole segment's about. Hopefully it's okay. Tell me what you think below, and we'll keep on going with it.
What do you do when a guy wants your love, but he never makes the first move?
Okay, I can go so many different routes with this question, depending on your perspective, okay? So I'm gonna jump around. The first thing I wanna say is, why does he have to make the first move? Why don't you make it? Okay, like, why don't you make it? Make it easier for the guy, you know? Now, you can say, well, that's not how it works, that's not fair to me and stuff like that, but let me tell you something. Newsflash. I feel like if this guy really, really, really loved you, you would not be talking to me about this. He would do what he has to do to come forward and obtain your love, right? Or move forward with you. I know how it is because there's a girl in my past who I was friends with and I was just obsessed with her. I mean, it was eating me alive for her not knowing how I felt. So I eventually came forward with it, right? So what I'm trying to say is, does he actually have the feelings that you think he has, or is he just telling you bullshit? Which gets me onto the second thing. I feel like if you're saying he loves you and he said that, I might question his motives. And the reason I come to that conclusion is pretty much, like I said, if a guy truly, truly feels this way for you, he'll do something about it, number one. And number two, I always say there's two ways a guy goes about getting a girl, right? There's the offensive way, which is a guy approaching her, you know, hey, I like you, let's go out sometime kind of thing. And then there's the more defensive, which is the girl maybe is a high value, scarce woman, and it's like, okay, well, I need to make the move, because if I don't, she's either going to leave, she's going to be fed up with it, or another guy's going to come in and sweep her off her feet, and I lose my chance, my opportunity. Okay, which he's not doing, which again tells me the third thing, which is a lot of women would say, well, he likes me because he does this, 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 and this. I'm like, okay, cool, but let me flip it around on you. Why are you talking to me then? Because if a guy truly likes you, he wouldn't still be on Tinder. He wouldn't tell you he didn't want a relationship. He wouldn't, he would make the move. He would commit to you. Why is there big gaps between your texting and talking? Why is he going all this space and time without even reaching out to you? Why is he doing this, that, but, you know? And women are like, oh, well, but he did this though. Then why would he reach out to me? And she's not understanding what I'm trying to say. You know, I feel like if a guy truly likes you, let me sum this up, truly loves you, like you asked here, he would make the first move, right? Now, the only reason I can say that he's not is because he's not at that do or die stage, in my opinion, which is he might be afraid of making the move. He might be a little nervous, maybe risk of being turned down, and the risk isn't worth the reward yet. Like I said with my friend, it wasn't eating me alive yet until the very end, where I was like, okay, you know what? I'd rather just her know than this be built up inside me. So I personally think he's either bullshitting you, his back is in against the wall, or you need to make the first move. That's just my opinion.
Okay, let's say your boyfriend is seeming sad or something, and he won't tell you what's wrong. How do you get him to tell you what's wrong?
Okay, I can see several problems with this situation. One is the way you word it, right? You said that basically, you want him to tell you, or how to get him to tell you what's wrong. And I feel like that's a very forceful or pressuring type of way of going about it, right? I tell people all the time, if someone's not ready to tell, I don't care if you're fucking best friends, if you're butt buddies, I don't care if you've grown up from the age of 5 and you're 55 now, you've been friends for the last 50 years, who cares? If you're not ready to tell someone something, they have no right to tell. They're under no obligation to tell you. Okay, I don't care. And if you And here's the big mistake a lot of people make. If you're going to go about and say, you're my girlfriend, you could tell, or I'm your girlfriend, sorry. I mean, unless you're into that, whatever. But I'm your girlfriend, you could tell me anything. That's really going to make them mad because it's very condescending. It's very condescending to say this. Like, well, no shit I can tell you. It's not like I'm a pedophile, you know. That's not what's wrong. It's not like I murdered somebody. Of course I could tell you. I'm just not ready to do it. And people would say, well, that's the wrong way to go about it. That's the problem with relationships, is lack of communication. I would actually say the opposite thing, that is the fact that you think you're entitled to that kind of stuff when he's not ready to it, which is the actual problem of the relationship. So what I'm trying to tell you is you need to get up into his dome and say, hey, I really like you. I know there's something wrong. You don't have to tell me. I totally understand, but I'm here for you. That's all you gotta say. Simple as that. Build his trust, have him win that trust over, and then go from there. I think forcing it is the absolute worst thing you can do, especially because you don't know someone, man. I'm telling you, I read a quote the other day, and they say you're not ready to marry someone until you've seen them go through financial hardship, lose a loved one, and something else. I forgot what it was, but and I was like, well, that's really true. Not that I would wait for all those things to happen, but you don't truly know someone as well as you think you do. You know, so let that person come to you. Let that person open up when they're ready. And I think you would get a lot further in the situation.
Why do guys change their texting and talking patterns out of nowhere?
I don't really think a person's texting patterns change all of a sudden, like abruptly, right? Now, the action might do so. One day he might text you, the next day he stops talking for 2 or 3 days, and you're like, well, what the hell's going on? You know, this is a different pattern from him talking to me every day and initiating for the last 2 weeks. But if that happens, trust me on this, ladies, it's not like he just wakes up one day and is like, ah, you know what? I'm going to stop talking to her today. I'm going to mess with her mind. No. That's not really how it works. I feel like it's something he's been thinking about for the last several days or a week, right? It's something that's been on his mind. And I usually tell women it's for two reasons, especially with nowadays, with all the competition, the social media, the dating apps, the convenience of finding someone else, replacing, which sounds so bad, but that's just kind of how it is. That's why they say Tinder's a hookup site, you know, and things like that. With all those things being so easy and so convenient, you know, literally in the palm of your hands, the reason a guy would stop talking to you, one or two reasons, is the pressure of moving too fast, too soon, maybe not being what he wants, or another girl coming into the picture. So when a guy stops texting you all of a sudden, I personally think it's the path the relationship's going down. If you guys are moving too fast, too soon, he realizes it's not what he wants, he has a very hard time to keep on complying with you and going along with it. Because if he does so, then it's telling you, hey, everything's hunky-dory, we're on the same page, when you might not be. I don't really think a lot of the times it's because of another woman, because it's like, if there's another woman's in the picture and he's not really looking for a relationship, then why would he stop talking to you? Why just not talk to both of you and date around? Just like both of you, just like you should. I tell women, you should date around till you find a good guy that you want to settle with, and then push all the other ones away, right? Don't do that one at a time shit. So I don't think the reason is another girl in the picture. I think it has something to do with you guys on different pages. Maybe he felt like he wanted something serious, and then it got serious and he realized, okay, this isn't what I want. Or maybe you did something, said something, I don't know, that kind of triggered something in his mind that said, ooh, I don't know. Because like I said, you have to be on the same page to end up going down a relationship. You know, if a guy's not looking for a relationship and a woman says something as simple as, I'm looking for a relationship, but I want to take it slow, let's see where it goes, okay? Even though you say that and you're not pushing technically for the relationship right now, you are, because you already carved that path. He's just walking down the path very slowly, if you want to think of it as that analogy. You know, so it's like, yeah, we're moving slow, but it's still towards a relationship. You have an outcome, an end goal. He likes to go in and just kind of freeboat it, right? Just go by ear. Whatever happens, happens. And that's usually where the tension and communication breaks and a guy stops texting or talking to the girl. That's just my opinion, okay? So with that being said, ladies, if you want some more questions answered, just leave the question below in the comments. Subscribe if you haven't yet. I love you. Take care. It was great making a video again, and peace.